IT Idiots would like to thank UK2.net for sponsoring the show, the UK's largest provider of web hosting, providing the content and bandwidth distribution for this show.
It's Friday, it's July 7th, and you're joining us once again for IT Idiots, episode 14. I'm Nicholas Hill, and once again, joined by Nicky Curtis.
Hello.
No Shabby Nackvi again.
But he might show soon.
He may do, so we may have to have words with him.
He was meant to be here about 2 hours ago.
He knows what time
and,
we start filming.
He's missed so many podcasts, and it's just getting beyond a joke now, so we're going to review his
status. I think we are. He's got a review coming up, and it's not looking good.
It's not looking good at all.
So how are you doing, sir?
Yeah, not bad. Cool. Not bad at all. What have we been doing? Nothing.
You're working very hard, have you?
No, yeah, just finished. Well, work's boring to talk about and stuff, but yeah, just finished a big marathon working 3 weekends in a row, so my first line for a long time tomorrow, so I'm looking forward to that. But other than that, just working hard again still.
Okay, sounds quite good.
What's your factory doing? Are you still building it?
Still building it, still getting everything together.
Yeah.
Been trying to learn a lot about Linux this week.
And you get Oompa Loompas in it?
Oompa Loompas and everything.
I know you can get Polish people on
there. Oh, yes, I'm looking at some Polish stuff. But yeah, no, I've been looking at getting my own dedicated server. And so
communicated on that?
Possibly. And yeah, been learning sort of how to go about administering it and all the control panels and everything, so I'm not amazingly up on that. Previous job was just a case of write some stuff and deploy it in IIS, and everyone else took care of security and connections and this, that and the other.
We didn't really worry about security so much back then, really.
No, even towards the end of my career, as I like
and
to
as
think.
A developer, you still don't give a shit about it, do you?
I still do. Well, now I have to, because it's my own company that I'm looking to protect.
So
I have no choice, which does annoy me somewhat as a developer. But no, I've got some great and interesting news. We have a guest 1 week only sponsor.
Oh yeah,
we do. We have
a chat, and I'll drag up Firefox.
Okay.
That's red means yes, doesn't it?
It does. It means we're capturing. We had a shock last night. We had a very generous donation from pdfsolutions.co.uk.
What's the guy's name?
Stuart Slaney. You should know that.
And I was. It was a question to tell people the name. Oh, isn't
okay.
It?
Sorry.
I'm a professional.
Gentleman Stuart Slaney. He comes from a Mac background and has just recently found us and found the episode on VMware was quite helpful and useful. So as
is it this guy SR?
No. He didn't post anything on
Greg
on,
podcast
on he
that
didn't
one.
Post anything on the website.
Oh, did you not?
No.
Oh, that was the email.
Yeah. So there you go. You've ruined it already. So anyway, we'd like to say
what was his website?
Can we
pull that up?
Yeah, I'm going to paste. It's already been pasted.
Oh, okay.
It's all done. It's all taken care of in the editing. So we'd like to thank you for that very generous donation, Stuart. I've got to admit, mate, I was stoked.
Yeah, because the email came through to me, I think, last night. It was quite late,
about
half 11.
Yeah,
and I forwarded it to you saying, I'm going to give up work. Some of that.
The money's rolling in now. So
yeah, we sort of got fired up at the podcast. I rewatched the VMware podcast because I didn't watch it since we gave it. And I thought, yeah, it's quite reasonable. And it looked like we were begging in it, Nick. It was a bit embarrassing. And I felt really bad because £50 is a lot of cash, eh? We weren't expecting that.
No, that was a very generous
donation.
So that
was really cool.
So thank you for that, Stuart. So anything that's PDF, any of your PDF needs, do go and give Stuart's company, PDF Solutions, a quick visit. I'm sure they'll be able to do anything that's PDF-based for your company.
Cool.
So there we go. So
I don't really know. Do you know much? PDF?
It's a document format.
Oh, is it Adobe? It is.
It is.
Okay.
It's portable document format.
No, I did have a quick look at. Well, I looked at the website and I didn't. It wasn't really my thing.
It looked all professional.
Yeah, no, exactly. But I didn't want to present something I don't know anything about. So, but no, go and check it out.
So, so we're not promising that everyone who makes large donations will get to do a weekly sponsor of the show. But hey, test us.
Yeah. And I think your website hit should probably go up by about. Two.
I was going to say,
well, I've been there, that's one, and you've been there, so we're getting shabby, so that's three. So, yeah.
Yeah, so thank you very much
So
for that.
smart. Yeah.
What else? I had a great email from a guy, I think his name was Danny. I apologize, whoever you are now. But he was basically saying that his boss recommended this podcast as kind of a fun thing to watch at work during your lunch hour once a week. It wouldn't do you any harm.
Oh, that's depressing, isn't
So
it?
he sent me a quick email saying, do you think you can sort of sauce it up a little bit? Because it's basically been approved by work. So he was wondering if we could put some topless tossie in it.
Oh well, have
So.
you seen? I shocked. We got another forum feed, and I don't know if you can show that. We've got an explicit tag, haven't we?
Yeah,
Wh
because
which one was it? Great podcast.
none of, it's not in
Oh
feedback. I
no, I
created a
see.
couple of. I did some work on the website this week. I've tidied it up. We've now got on the front page where you can go and vote for what you want us to do a podcast on. It's under your stories. Oh, no. The one you're thinking about is questions and answers.
The girl one.
Yeah.
Is that the girl one?
Yeah, we'll come back to the your stories in a little bit.
Because I actually got quite excited by this because I'm quite sad.
But
Which one? Feedback.
no, questions and answers. You see, the preparation that Nikki does is just absolutely outstanding.
SWF, this one.
I think that's single white female looking.
But
Not that I know what any of these.
I would like to know if Nikki would be kind enough to answer the following. Our current relationship, but would frankly would give it all up for you. So that was quite. And she sent a picture of
A rack.
what she's referring to as a rack. So I don't know if that's an American thing.
I think it
I
sounds very
don't quite
American to me.
reckon. But the thing I don't understand is it's top for hire. I'm not paying anything. Other than that, thanks, and keep them rolling in.
So it's the wrong kind of rack for you, isn't it?
It
It's
is,
not
yeah.
mounted in a server room.
It's not, no.
Otherwise, you would
And
have been
quite frankly,
interested.
I mean, does it
What are
come
you going
in?
to
Do
do with that?
they come in instructions?
I have no
I
idea.
don't know.
Okay, I mean, now there was also a contentious issue posting on
Yeah, which
here.
I want to tidy up because we're not liars. I've got a bit concerned about this one. Where is it? So I
It's
need to go back to.
in forums.
God, but this website's really hard to navigate.
Charmed. Now, if we go to your stories,
Now I went into it and I saw.
you've got two postings. It's kudos. Go to kudos.
No, this one, the Kevin Rose one.
Yeah.
Now, some of you might know Kevin Rose, Dig. We've mentioned Dig a lot, and you know,
So Kevin replied
they're absolute
to
heroes. And I saw this and I thought, no, hey Nick, it's been here a while. Sorry, I've not been in touch for such a long time. And I thought, I don't know. So I called Nick and I said, Nick, have you seen this posting? And well,
Well, I'm claiming it's real.
I don't. Well, basically, someone's taking the piss, which no, we're all for, and I love
Well,
feedback. But
definitely, definitely.
this is absolutely great. But we're not sad enough to do this ourselves. But we really appreciate someone going to the time because I don't think this is real. I wish it was.
It's great.
Because it'd be nice to tide in with
Basically,
that.
what happened was we said some nice things about Kevin last week. Somebody's obviously gone to the effort of producing a picture of the Dig Nation headquarters and sticking our photo up on the wall.
And then we've
So,
got another feedback that's accusing us, I think it's a joke email accusing us
of
of
being
making
blatant
this up.
liars.
And yeah, we'll
So
read
I don't
into
know. Go to the website and read it all for yourself. It
it.
makes for fascinating reading.
Yeah.
And there's people seem to have been putting a couple of other posts.
So it's going quite good now, isn't it? So we're building momentum a little bit.
It
The
is.
show's sort of changing, and we've got some iTunes good feedback now. So
Yeah. So
almost featured, and then
keep
that's it.
going, keep going. If we can get ourselves featured, it's going to do an awful lot for the show.
Yeah, another new thing that Nick's implemented on the website, actually, now I'm to mention that, is the voting thing, which is
I'd
really
actually
cool now.
click home rather than faff around. That's the one.
Not an application user. Yeah, so the idea now is we might update this. We've got a list of subjects which
I just created off the top of my head.
that we're not necessarily experts at all in presenting. We should be able to do a reasonable job on some of them. I'm going to add to this. And the idea is you tell us what you want us to do and we'll do it. And we need to look at that again.
Yes. Yeah,
Okay.
I'm with you.
So we do it. So today we're going to do a bit on command line, and that was based on some feedback and.
And one vote.
And one vote. No, it's 33% of our audience. That's
Sorry.
thousands of people.
Sorry,
So yeah, we're
okay.
going to do some command line today. I think that's good because.
We brought it down to its lowest common denominator.
Yeah, and
we're quite good at bringing things down to the lowest common denominator.
Oh, goodness, some tea, sorry. Yeah, because command line really important, and I feel now again working in the industry, not enough people know about command line scripting, how easy it is, how simple it is, and what you can do with some really, really basic tools which have been around since DOS days. Okay, so what I'm going to do today is, just go into the command line and
And this is going to be quite emotional for us because we knew each other back in the days
when we first got our PC.
when DOS was really sort of in its early versions and
I don't know, what was your first version? I mean, you were running
4 point
I think I
something.
was four, and the end of four, and then five was the big one that
Then
I ran
five was the
for
big
a
one.
long, long time. And I remember I had
Config.sys and
I remember
autoexec.bats, great
my
days.
first machine. I had a because it had a, I think 10 meg. I
No,
could
no, no.
have DOS and Wing Commander on it, which
It was
came.
a 20 meg hard drive you got.
Okay, well, I remember I could only fit DOS and Wing Commander,
Or DOS and
or
Windows.
DOS and Windows on it.
So it was DOS and
Wing
Wing
Commander.
Commander. What a
That
great game that was.
so
So
yeah,
DOS.
so a little bit on DOS, really valuable. Used it again this week to value some of the piping things I'm going to show you this
So
week.
the DOS thing is really just to show how far back the command line
Yeah.
stuff, which is still in Windows, has its roots, really, rather than the fact that people should be running DOS as an operating
Yeah, we're just doing
system.
that for a little bit of a laugh, but it shows you the commands, and the commands are valid that I'm going to show you in Windows Server
But
2003.
it could become a cult thing where people think, hey,
Let's go with
who
DOS.
needs Vista? Let's go back to grassroots where we do things at the prompt.
Exactly. There was a 286 web server on the internet that you could go and download pages from. It was running
Yeah, that's
16-bit
right.
version of Linux
That's
that I went
right.
to see this week in one of my boring
I'm sure I've heard about
times.
that before, but what else have we got? What else we got? Okay, yeah, one breaking bit of news is if you pull up, if you go to bookmarks, people might have heard about this story this week. Nick likes men. What?
Nick likes other men. Is that you, Nick? What's
I
that? Is
don't know, but that sounds
that a
awfully
bookmarks you
rude.
want to go to? Is
It
it this one? Yeah.
is,
Okay.
but okay.
Strange
What?
she's called it that.
Thanks for that, mate.
Okay.
Okay, this website, it kind of ties in with a story that people have been talking about, and
What
I've got
is
a
it?
theory behind it. This is the website whereby people who do a lot of BitTorrenting can insure themselves
Oh,
against
yeah.
being sued. Now, the thing is, I think I've put two and two together and come up with four. And that is that my dad's been following all these podcasts. He's really getting quite into his technology now, isn't he? Now, he was quite respected in his day in the world of insurance. I mean, I think when he was working at Direct Line, he was doing at least 30 sales per day, insuring everything from all types of cars. So I think he's tied together his insurance knowledge with everything he's learned from us, and I think he's now put together a new business. So I've come to the conclusion that it's my dad that's offering this service.
Okay,
There
it
we
could well
go.
be. I thought it could actually be the Federation Against Copyright Theft running this, the sort of like trying to lure people in. It would
Oh,
be
I
quite ideal.
see.
Maybe
Maybe
it's a
my dad's
synthesizer.
working with them.
Maybe.
Could be. So there we go. That's my theory. I think my dad's behind all of this.
And your dad speaks new. What's that?
Well, I don't know. Maybe he got somebody to do the translation into Swedish.
Oh, you could Google that, I suppose, couldn't
I
you?
have no idea,
World
but
Cup, what's that about, ain't it?
I don't know. I
I don't
haven't
know,
got a clue.
let's
It
move
sounds
on.
like a
Move
crap
on.
conversation. But anyway, that was my conspiracy theory for the week. And it's not Nick likes other men.
Okay, right.
So back to DOS.
Back to DOS. So again, I'm using my trusty VMware. You saw me us use VMware and really sing its praises last week. I must say, again this week, troubleshooting work problems I mentioned with authentication issue with Novell and Active Directory. I've been spending so much time trying to solve that problem this week, and all done totally in VMware. So had Novell server running, Active Directory running, XP client, 2000 client, and the problem is what we're trying to do is weaken the security of Active Directory, but it weren't having none of it. It weren't having none of it at all. And I was going down to network monitoring. You look at the sort of, this might be a bit boring, look at the authentication packets, and it's using NTLM first, but when Active Directory sees it, it says, no mate, you're Windows 2000, you can do better than that, use Kerberos. So it forces it up to use Kerberos, and because the challenge it first sends out says ARM 2000. And I even put a firewall in between them, and I thought I'd block the Kerberos port to see if it drops back to NTLM, but sadly not. So that's what we do with VMware. So VMware is absolutely great, and sponsor us. And what I'm doing is just running DOS in VMware at the moment. So I think we
Okay.
ought to see this old beast boot up.
It's a beautiful screenshot.
It is.
Oh, I
So
really should apologise. Sorry for the late release of last week. All sorts of issues in rendering the, and then uploading, and then deleting, and so it was our fault. We filmed it nice and early. Thought we're going to get this released nice on either Sunday evening or first thing Monday morning, and you end up getting it the latest you've ever got a podcast. So apologies for that.
But we got our feedback instantly after it was released, wasn't it? So that's nice to
know
that people are actually watching
rating,
it.
You know, the number of subscribers is going, really starting to notice that going up.
Yeah, again, feedback's really cool, because otherwise we don't know anything.
I mean, to be honest with you, we put a reasonable amount of effort into this. I mean, I know we go on about the fact that we just get together and put it together, but we do put in quite a bit of effort. And to be honest with you, the reward and the thing that motivates us
to keep going is
feedback. People coming onto the website and actually posting stuff and sending us stupid emails and doing stupid postings of their racks.
Yeah, more racks, please.
And more photo chopping of us.
Racks at IT this time. I don't know what a rack is. I've never heard
it's
it.
It's a rack.
I've never heard that before.
It's definitely an Americanism.
Anyway, so DOS, how can we start? Well, I suppose the basic things in DOS, let's just go around DIR now. Hopefully, again, you guys know what DIR does, directory.
Don't look at me as if I... What do I know? Do I know?
You bloody know, don't you?
I don't know.
No. It's not LS.
Where's my from bat?
No, doesn't do LS. Okay, so we're just going to do very, very quickly basic creating folders, that kind of thing. So, you know, here's my directory. So the root of my C drive, type of DIR, and I can see I've got a couple of folders there, a couple of files, etc. Now, I can see there's a directory there called DOS, and in Windows, if you've never used the command line before, that'd be a little folder. And if I want to see what's in that folder, I can do cd, change directory, cd, DOS. And now I'm the DOS one, as you can see in there, type dir, and I can see all the files in that.
Now that's dirty operating system, not denial of service for you kids out there.
So that's those are the things in there. Now,
MemMaker.
Oh, Jesus, blast from the past. Well, have a look at the config system a sec. So if I do a dir slash question mark, and most of the command, when you're in Windows 2003 or, you know, most operating systems, well, actually, I don't know about most, but I think Linux has got man, you do the command or something.
So it's only anything that's Windows-based?
Windows-based, yeah. Just do the command for slash question mark, and it normally gives you help. So we can see here.
And that's on any command?
Yeah,
which is super. It's a lifesaver, isn't it?
It does cd for slash question mark. It does, but it does.
Can you do question mark forward slash question mark?
No, I'm not going to try that now. So let's go back to
almost knows you into it.
So what can we see? I want to show everything in subdirectories. So if I do a dir
slash
forward slash s, w is wide.
Yes,
all, can I know. Remember that. S shows me everything in this directory and all the subdirectories. Now again, that's probably not that useful to know Windows Server 2003.
Did you see how quickly that ran? Do you remember in the early days when you used to do that in the Windows directory? It could run for minutes.
It could do. Yeah. How much have you got on this? Got seven.
Control X, Control C. Good ways of breaking out of things that are running on the command line.
Yeah. Die.
Die. You're not in a telnet session.
Threats. Okay, so what else can we do now to make this interesting?
Let's
go through, I think what I want to show you is just piping.
Yeah.
You know, the ability to pipe the output of commands into a text file, make them a lot more usable. Because that's one thing which, again, I almost use on a monthly basis to solve a problem, is just being able to pipe the output of a command to a file and then search through that file.
Sure.
So let's just take something. I want to find out all the .exe files on my hard disk. So if I do a dir star.exe, star is a wildcard, show me all the files that end in .exe.
I'm going to pipe.
And I want to see all of them
right.
on the screen. Okay, and I want to record all of this. Oh dear, it scrolled off the screen. You know, that's a pain, isn't it? And DOS doesn't have a scroll bar, unfortunately.
It doesn't.
So what can we actually do?
We could pipe that.
We can pipe it. So what I can do, if I just hit return on that, it puts the output to the screen. What I can do is say, and I put the output of that into a file called c:\exes.txt. Okay. Hit return. And now if I do a dir, I can see there's an exes.txt. And if I want to know more about that, I can just type in edit.
Exes.txt.
What have I put notepad in there for? Oh my god, what's going on? Exes.txt. And we can use page up and down on that. So that's quite useful to know, just to pipe things. So, you know, in Active Directory, what you might want to do is show all the users in Active Directory. So you could issue a DS query user and then do a greater than sign users.txt. And, you know, it's not a great document, but it is documentary evidence of what you've got at a particular time.
And you can print that out.
It is, yeah. It's
then there.
It's pretty good. Now, the other thing I want to do is let's find
batch
out.
Batch files? Sorry, have I misinterpreted what you were about to start doing? I've ruined the link and
You've
everything.
ruined it now, yeah.
Oh.
So I was doing piping, wasn't I? Poor Nick interrupted me. So another thing which I really like is another command, which again I used in Windows Server 2003. There are probably better ways of doing things in VBS script if you're Wiz or something, but you know, some of the basic things you can get results from, and that's find.
VBS scripting could be worth doing an episode on. Sorry,
Yeah, it
just
could
whilst
be
I think
actually,
about it.
yeah.
If it's of
Yeah,
interest,
put it on
tell
the poll.
us. Put it on the poll.
Okay, so I want to find out how many EXE files I've got on this hard disk. How am I going to do that?
Ooh.
Well, I've got a text file containing the EXEs in it now, haven't I? So what I could do is,
I'd put that into, I'd then take that text file, I'd put it into Excel, and then just count the number of rows.
you could do on that. But if you have a look on this, I could count all the EXEs on this file, couldn't I? It's made it slightly easier.
Think there might be an easier way of doing it.
Well, but there is an easy way of doing it, because what I can do is use this application. Oh, is it an application, a command? I'm not with it this afternoon, guys. It's Friday, isn't it?
It's Friday.
Did I work today?
You did.
I did.
You've worked for
Jesus
30-odd
Christ.
days straight.
Okay, so find. Well, find would allow me to do is search through a file for the existence of a string. You know, so I can have a look and say, well, if we look at what's common to all of these, is they all have the word exe on the line, don't they? So if I search this text file and get it to show me all, or tell me all the lines with the exe in it, that will, you know, give me the result. Now you've got to be careful because there might be exe nested in some of this. So, you know, but sometimes it might just be quicker to edit the file, you know,
Yes, get rid of
to
it.
get rid of it. Yeah, because you can do this really quick. The idea is you're not planning to do it this slowly. You just do it quick because you're going to
Sure.
know this so well. So let's exit out of that. So find again. Don't know how to use it. Do a find for slash question mark. I'll do that very quickly. And what I want to do is I want it to count the number of lines. Okay, so we can see find for slash c is count the number of lines containing the string exe, and then I can specify the file I want it to search in. So that was cexes.txt.
Dot TXT.
Okay, so I know there's 50 exes. Is
58.
that 58? Oh, this is crappy.
But
So there's 58 in there.
now the beauty of it, I mean, I remember going back. I haven't done this kind of stuff in a long time because obviously my work doesn't really take me down this road. But it's a great way of very quickly comparing directories to make sure, have I got an exact copy? Have I got the same number of files in here
Yeah.
as I had in there? Same number of this type of file, that type of file. And as you say, once you know how to use it, it's 2 seconds work to quickly go and use
Yeah, I
it.
mean, give you another example. What I could do is say, don't count them, but just show me all the lines that have exe in it. Oh, insert. Okay, so this is actually going to show me all the lines. Okay,
And
well, what I just did there,
you could
what
actually
I
pipe that to a file now as
actually,
well.
do you know what? I think I did that. I said, show me all the lines that don't have
That
exe
makes sense.
in. So I'm just going to use my for slash question mark again. Yeah, so it's.
You did you do forward slash V?
I did, yeah.
Yeah. Display all lines not
Not.
containing.
I want it to display not line numbers.
Display line, no. Display only the count of lines containing
I think you just don't specify
finally
anything.
anything.
Yeah, there you go. So you look at the original file that showed me all my exes. It had directory listings in, and now you could say I've cleaned that up, and let's put that into clean.txt. So the output's now in there. So I've done something not very useful on the directory structure, but you know, using those commands, it'd be very, very easy to extract a list of users, you know, with DS query into a text file. You know,
Is that the kind of thing you, I mean, what are the real world examples that you
well,
find are useful for this?
well, this one's a great one, and I'll try and show you in Windows Server when we do it a bit later on in this episode. So the loss of this will be a lot more relevant, I think, to probably what you're doing if you're sort of in the IT world now. What was I saying? Yeah, I was using find. So last week, you might have heard me say I was going through an ADMT migration, Active Directory migration now, and it involved moving a fair amount of computer accounts from one domain into a new Active Directory domain.
Right.
And I did it in a chunk of 300, so I took 300 machines and moved it in. Now, the way ADMT works is it targets these machines, runs a little agent, they change the domain, and they change their domain and reboot.
Okay.
So it's all automated, but from the main machine that you're targeting from, if there's any problems, it will generate a log. So you've got this huge log. Now this log file is absolutely massive, and it's got so much information in it. And I don't know if you guys have done any EMT, but they're not all going to work. You are going to have some of the
Problems.
machines which aren't switched on.
Oh, we
You
are.
know, there's one thing, or there's some kind of problem with the machine. So the problem is, I had this large text file full of, thousands of lines of rubbish, and I knew that error code, I think it was 2065, said the machine name had failed.
Okay.
So what you could do there is you could say find. And this is exactly what I did. And they were actually amazed that you could do this. And I thought, you can do this in DOS 6.2, mate. Find error 2065. Oh, I'm going to have to put insert. In the name of. Obviously, you've got American keyboard on again, haven't I? In the log file, obviously making this up, this ain't going to work because I don't have that log file. And then you could pipe that to a text file, and then you've got a nice clean file of all the machines that have failed. Now, again, you could probably find many uses for that when you're installing your SQL Server, your Exchange Server, anything. Use find to find the keyword error, and it will show you all the lines with that keyword error. Or if you're looking for a particular numbered event, you might be, looking on TechNet and looking for a particular number in there. You could easily show it, easily.
Okay, and do you, out of curiosity, when you're doing all of this, keep these as a history of all the work that you've applied to the job, or is it this, you would throw this out
Well,
afterwards?
it depends. You might find it useful. I mean, for the ADMT, when I was searching the logs, I just wanted that information so we could go and address them manually.
Oh, you can
But
turn them on.
you can switch them on or say they're NT4, rebuild them. Don't worry about them, things like that. So it very much depends what you're doing it for. If
Okay.
you're searching Active Directory for users, you could use it as a document.
Yeah.
Just
Okay.
change the font and it looks professional. You don't put it in
Import
Notepad.
it into Word.
Yeah. So that's one thing. So that's a little bit of piping. Now, another thing you can do, I just want to talk about with piping is
Oh, he's using the up arrow here for
I'm
anyone
using,
who's never used
yeah,
DOS.
some of you might have seen DOS key load when I booted the machine up, which allows me to do that, is you can do a double greater than.
Yep.
And that means don't create the file clean.txt, but append onto
Append
the
to
end of
it.
it. So that again could be quite useful for a sort of running history. Right. Now, some of the other cool things you can do. Now, what I had to do there, I wanted to find out the number of exe files on my hard disk. And what I had to do is do a dir, pipe it to a text file, and then use find on that text file. We don't need to do that. Because if I do a find for slash question mark, and again, this is useful in 2003. I know I'm using DOS at the moment. But we can see if I don't specify the drive. If the path name down the bottom there is not specified, find searches the text typed at the prompt or piped from another command.
Handy.
So what can I do?
You can
Should I do a
do
dir?
DIR, pipe that into.
Yeah. Now what I'm going to actually do, just to prove this works, if I do a dir forward slash s, that I don't need to do start.exe. I mean, this is not a very
This isn't.
efficient way of doing it. So let's do a dir slash s, and I'll pipe that. Now we do that with that vertical bar, so
We
shift
do.
and the thing next to z. I
Yep.
don't know if your keyboards are different. In America, wherever you are, and I'm going to say find bloody hell exe. Now I want to do find for slash c, don't I, to count the number of them,
To what?
count the
Ah.
number of lines that have exe in.
Thought you're getting cross again.
And I've got 62.
That's great.
Okay, so I had 58 the first time, 62. There must be a folder in there or something that's got exe
Exe
in
in
there,
it. Yep.
but. You guys probably get the point. If I do a dir star dot exe
Page it so
forward
we can
slash
look at the
s,
pages.
then we can see that's
So,
58.
yeah.
Let's do a bit of exploration, find out why the hell that 62 was there. So how I'm going to do that,
Well, you could then take the two.
going to do dir forward slash s, and I'm not going to count it. I want you to show me.
Yeah.
It's probably going to be more, so I'm going to need to pipe that to another file. I'm just going to call it test now. Okay, that. So we're doing a dir slash s, we're piping that into find, and we're taking the output of that and we're putting it to c:\ backslash test.txt.
That's editing
I
and
didn't
taking a
actually
look.
mean to plan that, but that's quite cool, isn't it? We're piping to something
And
and
then
taking the output of that. And
you
again,
put it into a file.
so let's edit test.txt. And okay, so we can see
Straight off.
auto execs in there, execs.txt is in there, auto exec. So again, a little bit of cleaning
There you
required.
go.
But cool, eh?
Cool utility. Now, the other thing, which you probably don't need to go into in detail here, is that if you've got something that you need to run all the time, is that you can put all these together into a quick batch file. So if you've got a number of lines that you start to build up into something quite complex that you want to run, even just on a regular basis, but not have to remember how what you typed in to get there, you just edit, put it all together, and save it as a batch
In a
file.
batch file. Okay, I think that's quite a
Yeah.
good thing to do now.
Okay.
Okay, so let's say I constantly want to find out the number of, again, I'm just making this up, the number of
EXEs.
EX or the number of somethings,
Yeah.
particular
Ah,
files,
yes. Okay.
on my hard disk. So what I could do is create a little batch file, edit. I'm gonna say find me dot bat. Now, edit again in DOS is just a text editor. You can use Notepad or you can use Edit in Windows 2003
Or fine.
or via Linux or anything like that. Or Edlin you can use in DOS as well. So let's edit find me dot bat. And what do I want to do in find me dot bat? I want to do a dir forward slash s, and then I want to pipe that to a find. And I'm going to do forward slash c, and then
You need to make this parameterized.
I'm going to do percent one. Now I might get this one wrong because I'm not sure if that works within the parenthesis. But if we put a percent one in a batch file, what that means is if I go to the command line and type find me space ABC, that ABC becomes percent one to the internal script.
It's the first parameter that
Okay.
gets passed through.
Fucking programmer talk. Try to show off, aren't you? Right, find me. Might not work. Oh, what a start. I want to find out how many TXT files we've got. Okay.
How many racks we got?
Oh, Jesus.
Oh.
So that was pretty good, actually, wasn't it? So you've got batch files and everything. So if you understand that piping, I think that would be so useful to you in Windows Server 2003. Really,
Excellent.
really. So what we're going to do now is.
Is it of any use to me as a programmer?
Nothing's used to use it. Well, no, I don't know.
Now, just a quick question for you
Before we leave DOS.
before we leave DOS.
Fine.
What did you use as a screen capture in DOS? Or what have you been capturing all the screen with in DOS? What application did you use?
You worried?
I am. No, I'm not. I'm
No,
just
'cause it's
teasing.
VMware.
No, I'm just teasing.
You fool. Yeah, what was
Oh.
that guy saying? Oh, why do I hate Sony? Or why does Nicky always take the mickey out of Sony?
Yeah.
Okay, A, Nick likes Sony, so that's good enough reason for me to hate Sony, just to sort of wind him up.
Oh, that's just great.
Now they had the nasty rootkit thing,
They
didn't they?
did the
Digital
rootkit.
rights thing, which really I thought was outrageous, and I'm sure Google that and find out more about that. And I don't know, that's really it. I don't like, again, they've got things all wrong with PS3. There's all power and there's no sort of artism behind it.
Yeah. They do make good products, though,
Well,
if
I've
they're
got a
running
Sony
them
camera,
right.
and I do like the Sony camera,
Yeah.
my little stills camera, so I'm quite happy with that. But no, maybe I'm being a little bit unfair on
You
Sony.
enjoyed your
But
Sony 29-inch TV?
no, that was always crap. The geometry on that was rubbish when I
Was it
bought
just
it.
yours? Because mine was great.
It was absolutely rubbish on that 29-inch TV.
What, on all of them
I
or
was on
just yours?
credit for years with that telly. I was.
Dude, every telly you've owned has had bad geometry, and that's because
You
you
take
open
the
up the
back off.
back and you twiddled.
You
So
could have rendered
anyway,
it perfect.
so the bottom line is Sony do make good products for any future possible sponsorship, but otherwise there's
No,
some
but generally, I
dislike in the
prefer the
IT
alternative, I've got to
headquarters.
say.
Right,
Apart from with cameras.
okay.
Laptops don't like.
Just out of curiosity, how many episodes have we got to do before we start looking at getting some premises and doing the launch party and stuff?
I don't know. Depends how many racks are coming. Right,
More the
what I'm
better.
going to do now, I'm just going to load up VMware, and I'll load up a Windows Server 2003 team that I've got. And the idea, I would just want to show you a bit of command line in Windows Server
Will
2003.
that actually start properly this time, do you
And
think?
what Windows Server?
The team that you've got running.
That's not running. I need to start another team. Stop commenting. It's technical. Don't you worry your little head, mate.
This is a bit above me, is it?
Yeah.
Come on, this is people's bandwidth you're using up. Oh, it's great. I can talk to you like you talk to Shabby.
He might be here soon, or he's waiting outside and heard us start.
No.
Okay, so I'm just loading up a virtual machine. Oh, I paused it last time I ran out.
Storing virtual machine
So this has probably
state.
got network monitor. This is probably me toiling to try and get rid of Kerberos.
So this was you were actually using this setup this week.
I was using this, and I was running the network on another on my desktop machine, on another using VMware on that.
That's fantastic.
Bloody.
No.
Right. So I'm going to go to a command line in this. Let me just tidy this up a little bit. Where's fit now? I don't mean going mental. Uh-oh. Oh, you know what I'm doing? Because it's paused them, it's restoring them one by one. Unfortunately, when it restores them like this, there is a little bit of a delay.
Not a problem. Why don't we
We might
use
have to
this
have
as an
another
edit
point.
point? Because we're going to run out of tape.
Okay.
And
By the time we come back, they'll all be up and running.
we'll smoke some cigarettes, get this all sorted. And, well, I'll smoke some. I'm trying to get Nicky to start smoking, but he just won't
You
do
know
it.
why next year, January, there's no smoking in the flat? You know in England you can't smoke everywhere? That extends to the flat.
Which flat?
This flat.
Okay, we're back, and we've been joined by Shabby. Long
Hi.
time no see. I take it you've been a very busy boy.
Yeah, so I've got a couple of prescriptions to do at the end of the day.
You've fully mourned the loss of Argentina and your team going out of the cup.
You supporting Argentina?
Oh.
Well, that's what we heard last week, so it must be true. So anyway, we're back with Nicky. We're going to dive straight in. Nicky managed to get his little issue sorted
It
with.
wasn't an issue.
No,
It
no,
was
no,
just
no,
like
no, no.
that.
It was just.
You're trying to blame Paul on me.
No, I'm not. I'm just. We didn't want to show people having to close them all back down and then bring them all back up again. So save on a bit of bandwidth. So we're using that time to just inanely witter on.
Okay.
So.
Yeah, what we saw before was we looked at DOS, and that was really exciting. You wouldn't understand anything. It's all command line, no mice or no graphics or anything, so way beyond you. So it's good you're on here. But now into graphics, dude, and what we're going to have a look at is how we can try and do away with the graphics and do the sort of graphical things and a text-based sort of command line thing. Right, so, sorry about that, guys. So you saw me use piping, or we did piping, didn't we,
Batch files.
and batch files. In DOS, let's have a look at how we can use those newfound skills in an Active Directory network. So I'm running Active Directory. As you can see, Active Directory user and computers behind, and I've got a list of users. Well, I've got a list of OUs. It's a mess. I'm not quite sure the last time I used this. I think I used it for a little bit of training. So the first thing I want to do is I want to find out all the users I've got.
Don't tell me,
Okay.
tell the shabby.
So I want to find all the users I've got. Now, again, there is a tool called DS Query, and I can type DS Query user and it will show me.
Oh, actually, tell me. I don't know what's that. This all sounds very. Oh,
Show me
wow.
a list of all of the users. Okay, so all of the user accounts I've got in the domain. Okay. Now, if you do DS Query user, it's got a lot more other things you can do with DS Query user. How would I find out about that? Shabby wasn't here, so Nick.
I
Again, I
think
know you know, but.
Forward slash
Question
question
won't
mark.
play long. God
Oh,
damn it.
sorry.
So forward slash question mark. And if I do forward slash question mark, it shows me some help. Oh God, it's gone off the screen. So luckily we've got a scroll bar which we can go up and down. You guys know we could also pipe it to a text file, print it out. There's no point doing that, but you guys get the idea. So have a look at the parameters you've got on DS Query, because it's really useful. For example, you can do a DS Query user minus disabled. Show the disabled users you've got. Now you imagine doing that graphically. Click there, click, oh no, it's whatever. And I know you can do searches graphically as well. But
So basically, what Microsoft have actually done, and this is actually a pretty good thing. They've maintained the power of the command line and DOS, and they've allowed you to continue using that even with some of their latest products.
Yeah.
So 20 years later, we can still harness that quick command line stuff,
I
but
think it
with
sort of comes
all.
from Unixy style, I suppose, originally and stuff.
Yeah, but let's give Microsoft credit for continuing with that.
Yeah, no,
They're
they are
not.
cool. And one thing they have done, which is really good in Windows Server 2003, is we do have these DS tools, DS Query. So we've got DS Query to find users. We've got DS Add to add users, or it's actually DS Add User, DS Add Computer, DSRM to remove.
DS Lite.
So what I've got here is a list of disabled users. Now, I'm not quite sure why some of these are disabled. Some of these are, inbuilt user accounts. But the first thing I want to do is I want to take that list away for a later examination. So I could do DS Query user minus disabled, and I can pipe that to a file, disabled.txt.
So what, these are your special needs users.
Kind of go there. Okay, so DS Query user minus disabled now goes into disabled.txt, and I could edit that. TXT.
So the C prompt that you wrote after disables them, and the prompt after the what did you just do just right now?
watch the podcast.
Yeah, I think you come in about 10 minutes later because you miss quite a lot, and you'll bore these guys. so you just keep down. You know, I know you're noisy every other week you're here. You know, you can't stop talking. So I've got a nice little text vest of all of these things down. The other thing we can do with that, I don't really want to do this, but let's say I decide I want to enable all of those users. So I could dsmod user. Now, normally what you would do here, and again, don't worry too much about tools, dsmod, dscreate. That's not the point of this. The point of this is just showing you basic piping and things like that, is I want to modify all of those users and make them enabled. So I could do dsmod user, and we pipe it into the other way. That.
Yeah.
/disabled.txt. And I don't actually know the command. I think it's minus disables. No.
You spelled disabled wrong.
Die. You've got die on the brain tonight.
Chevy's just turned up. Okay, no, and that did actually work. And what happened there is we've got DSmod failed on KRB. It can't enable that account, so it actually fails the first time it needs something. There is a parameter to stop it doing that.
Right.
And again, you can do DSmod user. Let's just quickly do that. DSmod user. What's this question mark? It's getting boring. Continue reports errors, but continue. So minus C, I want to do on that. So I can just do arrow up.
You don't want the die though.
I haven't got die, have I? Oh yeah. Was it minus C?
Yeah. I'm
all over the gap. Okay, so we can see there's succeeded up there for one of the accounts, and we can see some of these ones here have failed because they're system accounts.
Sure, fair enough.
But again, that's quite useful. Now, let's do a DS query user. I want to find out all the users who start with A. You know, so DS query user minus name A star. And we can pipe that into a text file. We can do some really, really cool things with this.
Excellent.
So, again, one of the things I mentioned I did last week was searching through log files. Now, I don't actually, do I have a log file? Let's just do a dir star dot log /s, see if I've got any decent log files. Okay. Maybe that was a bit stupid to search a star dot log on the whole disk. So let's just go into the Windows directory, and there must be some log files in here, yeah. So I think, is there a DC promo log file? See how useful the command line is?
It doesn't matter, just choose one.
So service pack.log.
Yeah, service pack.log. I always find that a riveting read.
Well, there's WM setup, that's a slightly smaller one. So I'm just going to have a look at that log file.
He was able to tell that by the byte size that was listed as part of his DIR, I think.
And again, this doesn't seem very interesting at all. There don't seem to be any errors in that. Sorry, guys. What should I do? Service pack, SVC pack.log. Right, so there's got to be something. I'm just going to quickly search for an existence. And imagine this is a log file and there was an error in there.
And I wanted to find it.
Now let's pretend that error was delayed.
Yeah, well, let's just find a delayed file. We want to find the files that were delayed.
Exactly. Let's find out what files were actually delayed. So, how could I do that?
Find. /. Actually, no, we're not.
But I just want to find the lines, don't I? Yeah. So, it was delayed. Now, I believe it is actually case sensitive. So, I want to find out delayed in file. And I can just put SVC pack.log. Okay, so again, it showed me all the files that are delayed. And again, so it doesn't take a genius to work out how useful that is. If you've got any log file and you're looking for a particular event ID, not only can you create another text file with the results in there, but you can also say, well, how many files were there or how many errors were there? Create a little batch file. Remember what we did in DOS, so you can place that with a parameter.
So now you can just go finding.
Totally reuse it all the time. So, you know, so find. Let's see if there was any errors in there. Yeah, so there was some
No
errors
work.
in there. Don't worry too much. There's little errors in log files sometimes, so you just need to read beyond that just to see.
You ignore them until such time as they,
Yeah, just reboot it afterwards.
you ignore them until such time as they actually cause you a real problem that you're noticing. And you say that IT isn't a riveting career that you would consider going into. Oh, shame on you.
So that's command line. So I think that was the cool things I've done recently with the command line, and that's DS query. I use that a lot, DS query, DS mod, and again, piping the output to a text file. The error log last weekend was very useful.
So the beauty here really is that you've just, again, once again, just showing people what the tools are, a quick idea as to how to use them, and people can go away and, learn more about them and basically start to utilize them and use them themselves.
Exactly, and those tools again, DS query, DS mod, DSRM, they're again really, really useful. For example, show me all the users who've got a telephone number extension 01 because it's changing, and then you could pipe that to a text file, do a DS mod, and then you could change the 01 to 0181 or whatever. So they're really, really useful. And there's lots of people. When I was training it, they used to think, oh, that's just exam stuff. You don't use it in reality. And well, not many people do, but they are
But they
useful.
should be.
They really should be because they are really, really useful. And you know what, guys? If you think it's useful and you find it interesting, we can do a whole episode on them because it does sort of warrant,
Okay.
because creating user accounts, there's lots of switches that are useful to know, and you need to understand the concept of distinguished names. So, if you are in IT support, you don't know more about it, and you want us to do an episode or you can't be asked to learn yourself, or I didn't mean that in a rude way, then we do one, and that's cool because
What
we could
was
do
the
that.
feedback? The best training that
Money
money
can't
can't buy, and I
buy.
liked that. I liked
No, that
that.
was really cool.
So that was command line.
That was command
So,
line. I'm going to stop the caption now because that's getting quite big.
okay. Well, thank you for that, Nikki.
That's all right.
So, well, thankfully, Shabby turned up, so we're going to be able to fulfil what we talked about at the start of the show. You've been with us now, Shabby, for 3 months.
How many episodes have we done in total?
Well, we've done 13.
This is 14, isn't it?
Yeah,
This
okay.
is number
So this will be
14.
the 14th episode, but we've done 14.
Okay, how many have you appeared in? Do you
About seven, eight.
Seven, eight.
I'm
So
sure.
I think about seven. So 7 or 8. So you've been with us for 3 months now. So it's your 3 monthly review. So how do you feel you're settled in? How do you feel you're getting on? And what's with not being able to turn up to work on time?
I think we definitely got an attendance issue because I seem to remember calling on the phone saying we're doing a podcast on Friday night, and what was the reply? Oh, I'll be straight away after work. Now, what time do you finish work? 6.
Yes, that's right.
Okay, it's fine. 10 o'clock. Jesus, so
It's
four
not
hours. So
very good. It's not looking good.
I'm sorry. Work took me away. I had tablets to count. I did delivery to do and.
Tablets to count. It must be hard life being a pharmacist.
Yeah,
You're going to have to make the call, young man, as to whether you really have your heart set on becoming an IT consultant and specialist, or whether, as Nikki described in episode one, whether you want to be a pill pusher for the rest of your life. Now, I think obviously you've made it clear that pharmacy is your chosen career, but we feel it's our duty to try and, well, switch you over to the dark side.
every time you involve Shabby, the worrying point is every time you involve Shabby, like just then you're talking, there's just lull points all over the gap, isn't there? Like now, look.
Watch. If me and Nikki don't say anything, let's see how long it. Let's see. Hold. Can you hold this podcast together for us?
Can't say much at the moment. No, well, I don't. You're doing DOS, aren't you?
It's just. What do you think we
Well,
should
you
do?
are going to cut this, aren't you?
Are we going to? I mean, the probation period's up, but what do you think? Do you think we're going to sort of extend the probation period? We're not going to fire you at this point.
We're not going to fire you, but you've got to. I want to see some sort of renewed enthusiasm towards this.
Okay.
Because, you're letting us down, and people are getting bored, I imagine. If anyone's still watching it, I think they'd probably realise that it's your time to talk, and they've switched off by now, so we haven't got any audience now.
And what have you done about the t-shirts out of curiosity? So he doesn't even watch the episodes he's not in. See, last week you agreed to finance and sponsor and pay for the t-shirts that we're going to be giving away to people.
Oh, did you email me? Let me know.
No, but I knew you'd be watching.
Did you
the
check your email? So you can't use that.
Yes, I did. Yes, Sherry, I did. I emailed you regarding this. I CC'd Nicky on it, and he got his.
I got mine digitally signed and everything. Oh, SSL. We got someone wanted to know about SSL, didn't they?
They did. Actually, yeah, that's something which we could.
We can't read it now, can we?
Oh, no.
5 minutes.
No. No. I'm bored.
Because it's just gone downhill again.
It has.
Okay,
yeah,
sure. I think we'll stop.
Yeah, I think we're going to, on this lull, on this absolute down note, you know, and I'm sorry. I feel sorry for PDF Solutions for the one episode that you sponsored. Shabby had to come back into it, but
this is 50 quid's worth, isn't it? So
it's got to be 50. It's got to be more than 50 quid's worth. So yeah, let's on this note, on this bombshell, we're going to wrap up this episode. So we'll see you next week, guys. But please, once again, continue to give us feedback. Come to the forum, post some stuff, because it's what keeps us going. Well, me and Nikki, anyway.
Shabby doesn't have to get there.
And yeah, so thanks ever for everything that you've done this week, and if you like it, go vote for us on iTunes. So thank you very much. Till next week.
Bye.
IT Idiots is sponsored by UK2.net, the UK's largest web hosting provider. With domains from just £1.99 and web hosting from just 40p a day, visit itidiots.uk2.net for weekly offers. Get your piece of the internet at uk2.net.
Well, that was also, wasn't it? He'll be crying himself to sleep tonight on his huge pillow.